Good morning, everyone. Welcome to or welcome back to my channel. It is 8:30 right now and I had set my alarm for like 7 because I wanted to have like enough time to do everything in my morning routine because I am meeting a friend at 11:30. I have to leave my apartment at 11. So I set my alarm for 7 and right now it's 8:30. So that obviously didn't go to plan. Also, I look kind of ridiculous right now because I'm having issues with my left eye. I think I'm having like a weird reaction to this soap that I put on my hands Friday night. I was at a restaurant with my friends and the hand sanitizer was like soapy and I must have like touched my eye at one point because at the restaurant it started getting really itchy and I was like scratching it. And then I woke up yesterday morning, which was Saturday, and it was puffy like this. So all day yesterday I was applying cream to it and kind of massaging it and the swelling went away. And now I just woke up and it's back. Also, I have a rash here on my chin and I put on a lot of cream yesterday, but it's still there. So anyways, today I'm going to be doing a little morning routine vlog of a typical morning in my life living in Paris. If you're new to my channel, hi, my name is Zoe. I moved to Paris from Canada in June. Now it's November, so I've been here for a few months. I'm working here in Paris, but today is a Sunday, so I'm going to have a nice little morning before I go meet my friend at 11:30. I have kind of a little routine that I do every morning, so I thought why not vlog it and do a little morning routine. So I hope that you enjoy the video. If you do, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Leave me a comment down below because I respond to every single comment. And of course, subscribe to my channel if you're not already. Good morning, Paris. Here is what my bed looks like when it's all made. I kind of want to get more pillows for my bed, like more throw pillows in front, but we'll see. That will probably happen in a few months. If you didn't watch my last Paris vlog, I just put up these posters, and getting these posters took like 4 months, so we'll see when I actually get around to buying more pillows. Now I'm going to do my skincare routine because that's the first thing I do every morning. It really helps wake me up. But actually, what I do before my skincare routine is on my way to the bathroom, I pass this little shelf, and if you have been watching me for a while, you know that I take these every single day. These are my vitamin D gummies. They taste like candy. They're so good. I have a lemon and I'll take a strawberry. My parents brought me like 10 of these from Montreal. No, it's okay. There's honestly nowhere for me to put the camera. I'm literally gonna wrap the legs around the sink. First thing I use in the morning is a cleanser. This is the Fulvic Acid Brightening Cleanser from the Inkey List. Next, I have moisturizer. I use the Complex 15 Daily Face Cream. I also have had this brought to me from Montreal. So now that I'm done the moisturizer, I'm going to add extra moisturizer. It is a triple repair cream for eczema to kind of treat my rash here and to treat my eye. So I'm gonna add a little bit of that. And then I'm gonna brush my teeth and let this like kind of sink in. And then I'm going to apply my sunscreen. This is the Supergoop Unseen Sunscreen SPF 40. Side note, how cute are my little like skincare and product shelves? Obsessed. Skincare's done. Now I'm going to get dressed because I conveniently don't have any ingredients for breakfast. So I'm gonna go to a bakery and get a pastry. Let's see what I'm going to wear. I have not pre-planned my outfit, so I have no idea what I'm gonna wear today. It's a little chilly, but it's not cold. What am I wearing? I haven't worn this yet. This like brown turtleneck sweater. Maybe I'll wear this, but it's a little cropped, so I need high-waisted jeans, so I'm gonna wear one of my Princess Polly jeans. Maybe my black Princess Polly jeans. There we go. Okay, I'm gonna try that on and see if I like it. Just got dressed. This is the outfit. It's still a little bit cropped, this sweater, even with my high-waisted jeans, but whatever. It's super comfy. I haven't worn it yet this season, and I only got it last winter, so I don't think I wore it that much, and I completely forgot how comfy it is. This is from Princess Polly. It is so soft. Literally feels like I'm wearing a blanket, so I'm not taking it off. And then these are also Princess Polly jeans. These are my black, like, what are these called? Crisscross jeans. Not the most fashionable outfit, honestly, but it'll have to do. I'll put my trench coat over it and call it a day. So now I'm going to go get myself some breakfast at a bakery, but I'm hoping that my favorite bakery has pain Swiss today. I usually get a pain au chocolat because they're like small, cheap, and not that much chocolate and sugar, but I actually have like a loyalty card at my favorite bakery, and it takes like 7 purchases to fill it up. So I've already filled up one, and then I have one right now that's filled up, and then I have a second one because I think I gave one to my parents when they came to visit me, and that one I need one more little signature on it. And last time I filled it up and I went to go like exchange it, you get a free pastry and a free like tea or coffee. So I wasn't gonna get a free pain au chocolat because I get those all the time and they're not very expensive. So I tried for the first time a pain Swiss and it was so good. If I get a pain Swiss, I'll show you like obviously what it looks like, but it's like longer than a pain au chocolat. It's kind of like this, like a rectangle, and it has layers of chocolate and chocolate chips and icing, but it's not too sugary. Like, it's still like a pastry. It still tastes good. So yeah, that's my new favorite pastry. And now that I have the little loyalty card filled up, I'm hoping they have a pain Swiss today because I'm not gonna like waste my free pastry on a pain au chocolat. And then since I don't drink tea or coffee, last time they let me choose one of the little like juices that they have, so I just got a peach iced tea. So let's go to the bakery. I'm so happy. However, apparently pain Swiss is not part of the like get a free pastry deal, which kind of makes sense because it's like 3 times the price of a pain au chocolat. But last time they gave me one, so I like picked out a pain Swiss and then like I go to pay and I gave the woman my loyalty card. She's like, oh, but a pain Swiss isn't part of this. And I was like, you're kidding, because I've like been craving it. So I was like, but they gave it to me last time. And she's like, and she was like, okay, we'll give it to you but with no drink, like let's do a little exchange. And since I didn't want a tea or coffee anyways, like I was gonna get a little peach iced tea, I was like, sure. Look at that. So it's a very long pastry, as I was saying, and then you can see the chocolate, little bits of like chocolate chips. That's the icing. I hope it's good. Made a little commotion in the bakery today. It's so good. So I'm going to eat my breakfast now, and I always eat my meals like breakfast, lunch, dinner with some sort of entertainment, whether it's like playing a game on my phone, watching a YouTube video, watching a Netflix show, whatever it is. Sometimes I actually do FaceTime a friend or FaceTime my parents, but right now it's 4 a.m. where they live, so that's not gonna happen. So I'm going to watch something while I eat my pain Swiss, and I'm actually going to watch a Skillshare class. I'm going to start a new Skillshare class today because I just joined Skillshare, and Skillshare is actually sponsoring today's video. I've always heard people talking about how Skillshare has thousands of classes that are actually really interesting, like how to start an online business, how to paint, how to grow your social media, tips for decorating your apartment, just any topic or any skill that you want to learn, they have a class for it. So I was really interested in joining Skillshare to see what I could learn and what type of classes could benefit my life. So when I joined, I was so surprised by how many class options there were on Skillshare for categories that are super relevant to my life. I already have a list of classes here that I want to try, like advanced video editing on Premiere Pro for work, creating habits that stick because I'm really bad at that, designing the life you want, which helps with motivation, and a class on productivity and time management because sometimes I'm really lazy when I need to get work done. I could have saved so many, but I decided to just start with these, and then when I'm done, I'll go back and choose more. So for the next little bit now, instead of watching a YouTube video or Netflix show with my meals, I'm going to be watching a Skillshare class. Today, I'm going to be starting the Designing the Life You Want for exercises for clarity and motivation class from Michelle B. So to make 2023 the year you perfect a new creative hobby, land a new career, or launch your business, for a limited time only, you can receive 50% off of a full year Skillshare subscription, which is their best value offer of the year. This isn't like other Black Friday deals you're seeing. This isn't about more consumption, more stuff, more clutter. This is about you, your passions, your curiosities, your creative spirit, your growth. This is about doing something for you all year long. long. So you should definitely invest in yourself this holiday season and take advantage of Skillshare's best deal of the year. For a limited time only, use my link in the description box to get 50% off of your Skillshare subscription. And now I'm going to do this class. It's only 22 minutes, so I'm going to do the whole thing right now while I eat my pain Swiss. How cute that is. You get little confetti when you finish a class. So that was really cool. Like, I feel like I spent my little breakfast time productively by taking a class that's gonna benefit my life, you know? But now it is 10:30 and I'm leaving to go meet my friend in half an hour. So now I'm going to continue getting ready for the day. I'm going to do a tiny bit of makeup, and also today's a hair washing day. I wash my hair at night though, so I feel like right now it doesn't look that nice. It's a little bit greasy, so I'm also gonna put a bit of dry shampoo in and then I'll be ready to go. I'm just gonna put a little bit of concealer here. I've had the same makeup routine since I was in eighth grade, but if you're wondering, my concealer is the Garnier Clearly Brighter Anti-Dark Circle Eye Roller. I've probably said that name about 87 times on my YouTube channel, maybe more. I love it. And now I'm going to curl my eyelashes with a Tweezerman eyelash curler. This is the Lash Sensational Maybelline mascara, and it's so good. I have to go to my mirror. I usually do my makeup at my mirror, but since I'm vlogging, I thought that I would do my makeup close to you. Oh my god, it looks terrible. Oh, I forgot I had that thick body lotion on my eye, and so the concealer's not blending in. Oh my god, it looks terrible. Ugh. Now I'm going to do my dry shampoo. I got this dry shampoo when I moved here, and I swear by it. Once I put this dry shampoo in, and my hair looked so good that I forgot to wash my hair for like 4 more days because I forgot that I hadn't put actual shampoo. It works so well. This is the Chlorane Dry Shampoo with Oat Milk, ultra gentle for dark hair. I also flip it over and spray here. Supposed to sit in for 2 minutes before you like brush through your hair. And I've actually discovered this new thing that I like to do. Instead of taking a regular brush and just brushing through my hair, I take my M scalp massager and I'm going to like massage my dry shampoo in while I let it sit for 2 minutes. I'm gonna go quickly wash my plate that I used for my pain Swiss. You guys, I'm ready to go on time. We did it. It is 10:56, so I just made it. I'm going to put on my trench coat from Uniqlo. I have my Casetify strap that I'm gonna put on my phone. I'm going to bring my umbrella, and then I'm also going to take a little tote bag to put my wallet, my phone, my umbrella in when I'm not using it. And I actually got a new Shakespeare & Company tote bag last weekend when Miriam was here. They have this limited edition tote bag. Since I'm such a huge fan of the other one, I had to get this one. So thank you so much for watching this little morning routine, very real morning routine in my life in Paris on a Sunday. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Leave me a comment down below because I respond to every single comment. And of course, if you're not already, make sure to subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!